guys, me Brian Friend Studios, and I'm back with another video, and today is Minifig Monday episode 69, and let's just not mention the date because those are pretty two meme numbers, but we have War Machine, and he consists of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So he has 8 pieces all together, and I do have a few modifications to this minifigure, so this is a bit custom, but basically in the set he came in, which was the airport battle from Civil War, he had a stud shooter that went on here, so I just switched it out and made put this gun on. So I think that looks a lot better. Also, I changed up his face. I gave him the scarif, their nose from, it was the rebel from the ATSD in Rogue One, from the Rogue One sets. So that's the face I used, if you guys are wondering. Because I thought it really didn't look like Don Cheadle at all, and I think this looks a bit more like him. So let's just put this back on. So as you can see, he has this really nice silver plate, which is really molded on black. It's just painted, and I think it looks really cool. They have a bunch of dark gray like lines and printing on it, and I think that looks pretty cool. He also has red eyes outlined in black, of course. And the rest of the helmet's generally black, and it's the same, you know, general Iron Man helmet. And he does have this really cool neck attachment piece, and it has like a clip, 1x1 modified clip piece. And, you know, that's pretty simple. But if we take all of this off, you could see the back printing, which is probably one of the first times I've seen this, because I really don't take this off at all. And also, I don't really have this figure positioned from the back, so I really haven't seen it probably since I put it together, so that's pretty cool. And then he has black arms and hands. Really wish they had started doing more arm printing on figures. I think if Lego has to do one more big addition to minifigures, just to include arm printing. And now I know they do arm printing generally, but those are for very special minifigures, and it's really not for just generic minifigures. Now, I'm not expecting them to make have a bunch of stormtroopers with you know, that they mass produce with a bunch of arms, with printed arms, but I think it would be pretty cool. I wouldn't say they have to necessarily dual mold them, but I think printing is pretty nice. And also, a figure like this, would, that came in like an $80 set, I think, is not going to be produced as much as a clone trooper would if they were to include one in a battle pack, because they're not producing as many of those sets because they're a bit bigger. You think about it, you, they're not going to have a, they're not going to have the same amount of UCS Falcons and have the same amount of battle packs, because they're completely different, and they know not a lot of people are going to buy an $800 Lego set. I'm not saying this came from an $800 Lego set. I'm just saying that they don't really mass produce figures, and that's just a little suggestion I have. And this is already 3 minutes long, so you can see the really nice printing he has going on there. I don't really know how. I recently just watched Iron Man 1, but I really don't know why he's an arc reactor there. I think it's to power the suit. I don't know what necessarily powers the suit. I thought it was just the suit powers itself, and it's not like his heart was. You know, he needs an arc reactor to keep the metals from piercing his heart, because he was never hit by shrapnel at all. So, really don't know why they do that. And then he has, I absolutely love the gunmetal gray color they have all over. His legs are very printed, probably one of the few Marvel figures that actually have really just amazing leg printing. And, yeah, that's it for this year, guys. Hope you guys all enjoyed, and I'll see you next video. Goodbye.